Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can make a fillable form in Microsoft Word. So what I mean by this, you can go ahead and create a form that, for an example, looks like this, where you can be entering text in places, you can be having drop downs, you can be having check boxes, you can even have a place to upload an image to. You can even do a calendar for an order date or whatever you need to order it from. And so there's all these different options in creating these forms, and what I like is afterwards, when you're done it, you can lock it down. So if you're sending this out to people, they can't type anywhere else and they can't move anything to change it up, and then they can go ahead and send it back to you or print it off. So today on Teachers Tech, I want to show you how you can create these fillable forms in Microsoft Word. So I'm going to start from scratch and building this form with a blank document here. The first thing that we're going to need to do is actually customize our ribbon in Microsoft Word. And to do this, all I'm going to do is go up and right click right up here. So when I right click, you can see I get a few options. I'm going to go to customize the ribbon, because the tools that we're going to use for today aren't set up by default on Microsoft Word. So what we need to do is go down on this side right here with main tabs and look for developer and just go ahead and click it and hit OK. So what it did when I clicked that, it gave me a new tab up top with developer, and then we can see the ribbon inside developer. And these are what we're going to be using right here, these controls to create the form that I showed you in the intro. So to start this tutorial here today, I'm on a blank page and I'm going to go ahead and add a header. This is going to be a t-shirt order form. So I'm going to add that to my header. So I'm going to go just double click in my header up here. You can see it says header. Now I'm just going to write t-shirt, and you can go ahead and if you want to make it for something else, go ahead and make it for something else. I'm just going to put t-shirt order form here, and I'm going to make this larger. I'm just going to highlight this and increase the font size. I'm not going to worry too much how things look for this example. And then I'm going to insert a picture. I'm going to say from online, and it will be just a t-shirt, and I'll just type this in. And we'll take a look. You can see it's Creative Commons here, and I'll grab a t-shirt from here. We will go with this one. You can choose a different one and shrink this down so it kind of fits a little bit better. And I'll just make this kind of fit here, and I'm just going to go ahead and center this. Just going to make it look a little neater. But again, you can change this any way you want. I'm going to just double click back down below the header. And when I'm inserting the different controls that I showed you from the developer tab, I like to insert things into a table. You don't have to insert them into a table. I just like creating a form in a table. I just find it keeps everything look neater and a way I can kind of plan my page. So I'm going to go up to insert, and I'm going to go to table, and I'm just going to kind of pick by four, and I'm just going to put a 4x4 table. I can delete rows or merge or split cells if I need to going on, but I'm going to start with this right here. So now I can go back to my developer table and I can start to create what I want in it by adding the controls. So I'm just going to go ahead and add teacher name to here. So in my example, it was just a teacher ordering t-shirts for their class. So I'm going to go ahead and just type teacher here, like so. And if I wanted, actually, I'm going to add teacher name. And if I wanted this bolded, I could go ahead. I could go and make sure you enter the home and then center it. Or if you wanted, I'm going to right align mine here. And the first thing that I want to do is enter one of those developer controls right into this spot. So what is it going to be? Well, it's going to be the one of these ones to enter text. I could actually use either of them. This one is more just simplistic. Here, this option, you can do a little bit more with the text or change things in it. But I'm just going to go ahead and enter this, and you can see it says tap here to enter your text. I'm going to stretch this table out here just to give it a little bit more room in case they have a longer name, and you can adjust that the way you want. The other thing that I can do now is put the grade here. So it's going to be a teacher, then I want them to give me their grade. So What is it going to be? Again, I'm going to go and I'm just going to bold all these, and I'm going to go back to home and align to the right, and I'm going to drop to do a drop down box here. So if I go up to developer and I'm going to go ahead and put in a drop down box, there's two different lists for drop down that you can do. This first one allows you to the person to actually add their own to it, and this one they can't add their own. So maybe in this case I'll do this one to begin with, and if they were not part of a grade they could specify and they could just write in their own answer. So if I go and choose this, it says choose an item. Now if we go up to properties here, you can see we have some different options. I'm not changing this information up here. The one thing I can show you is that if you do this to start end tag, hit OK, it kind of shows that this is one of the controls in here, but you don't need to have that on. So I'm just going to go back to properties and turn it back to here. And I could do the same thing over on the text one that I put to. But what I want to do is actually add my grade level. So what I'm going to do is down here, I'm just going to go add. And I, for my example, I'm going to add 6 grades. So I'm going to put grade 1 and I'm going to go all the way through to grade 6. So now I've entered in all 6 here. I'm going to hit OK. And you can see we have a drop down. So at this point, someone could go ahead, write their name in, and then they could go here and pick their grade. So you could either force it over, or if they wanted to write their own, if they just click into here like so, they could write maybe it's kindergarten, like so. So it's that has the option where you can write something in, not like the other one, and I'll give a demo of the other one. Some other things I just wanted to point out, if you didn't want to see the table lines, remember with any of these here, if I was going back to home, we do have a table here and we could say no border. Everything is still there. The different cells are there, but if you didn't want to see them at the end, remember you can hide the lines. I'm just going to keep the lines here and you can adjust that at the end. So we have our first row in here with a couple, and you can adjust the size here if you wanted to give more room to any of these like this. Let's go on to the next one, add another drop down with school name. Now I'm just going to go ahead and enter school name. I'm just going to paste that in. I'm just keeping my line to the right and bold on here. And I'm going to go back to developer, and this time I'm going to add this list here for the drop down. So when I select this, and I'm going to go back up to my properties. I do want to point out design mode. If I click on design mode, it shows me where the different controls are in it by showing it on each side. I'm going to turn off design mode. If I go to properties, I'm going to just enter quickly 3 schools into here, and I'm not going to change anything else. So I got my 3 different schools in. I'm just going to go ahead and hit OK. So at this point, you could choose one of these, but now if I try to type in that spot, it's not going to let me. So that was the difference between this list dropdown and this one here. I'm going to go ahead and actually just merge these cells because they don't need two separate ones. I'm just going to hit merge like this. So on my next row, what I'm going to put is the t-shirt size and quantity. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that right over here. And I'm going to split these two cells here. I'm going to actually do a little bit more here. I'm going to merge these ones. And I'm going to go ahead and split these a little differently. I'm going to just split them like this so I can add a title over top of them to just make the directions look a little bit more simple when people are filling this out. So I just want 2 rows and 1 column. And I'm going to type in size for this one, and I'm going to type in quantity for this one right here. So I have those, and I'm just going to highlight it a little bit different color so it stands out here. So I'll just give it a kind of a light gray, like so, and just do bold. All right, so underneath these, this is going to be a place where we're going to do our checkboxes. So I'm going to add checkboxes down below, and we're going to just start with we'll put our sizes. So I'm going to just go 3 to 6. It's going to be the first size. I'm going to hit enter, and I'm just going to enter in a few different sizes. So I have five different sizes, and I want to be able to have a checkbox next to the ones that they choose. So if they were picking one here, I'm going to go back to developer, and this is the checkbox here. So I could go ahead and click. Then I just can move down and select different ones too. I do want to point out you can copy paste these. So if I just go Control C and move down and Control V, I can also do that to each of these to put them in front of them. So the other thing I want people to put in is the spot for they can put quantity. And in this case, all I'm going to do is do the exact same one that I begun with. And now I'm just going to go ahead and do a quick copy here with Control C. And if I go after this, I'm just going to hit enter and do this a few different times here just by hitting enter. I know I need five times, and I want them to line up with across from them. Oops, like so. So we have our five different ones. Now someone would come through, they could enter multiple ones, they could check off. And I want to point out, if we go to properties for the checkbox here, take a look, we do have our symbol that shows here, an unchecked symbol. You can change these if you wanted a different symbol in here. Then in this case, they could go through, then enter in a number over here to put quantity in. All right, so we got our first few set up here. Let's move to our next line. I'm just going to go ahead and add three more rows here, and I'm just going to do this by hitting tab of these. So three more like this. If again, I could delete them or add them later if I wanted to. In this one, this is going to be the payment method here, and I'm just going to go and merge these ones together just like this. And then I'm going to put our payment method down here. I'm just going to paste it over like this, and then I'm just going to again line it to my right. And I'm going to do another drop down box that I'm going to just fill in very quickly here. So I just did a quick payment methods here. You can see cash card to PayPal. You could add more things like check or whatever you want to here. Now, at this point, I want to do something different, and I want the people to be able to upload a logo for their t-shirt. So again, I only need the two different columns. So I'm going to go and merge these here. So I'm going to type in upload logo like this. And I'll just go through and do my bold and align here. Make sure I have the line in the right spot. And at this point, I'm going to go back to developer, and this time I'm going to choose the image right here. So I'll go and click image, and it puts this in. So what allows me to do now, if a person gets this form, they click on it, and this pops open, they could go, you can see the different options. If they go from a file, and I have just an image here, insert, they could upload that image to it. So again, if they were sending it back to me on this finished form, and after they saved it, this would be in it, or else they could print it off and this would show too. So let's move on to our next one, and that's going to be the order date. So I'm going to type in order date here, and I'll just bold it and align it here. And order date, you can see, is just going to be with the developer. We have a little calendar right here. And if you go to properties, you can see some options on how you want it to read. So you can go through and pick which one and just pick what works best for you. Hit OK. So now when they do the drop down, the calendar comes up and they can pick a date like this. The last thing I'm going to do for this order form is just put a place for some additional notes, and that's just going to be this control right up here. So let's say we have all our things that we want to put into our order form. We want to be able to lock this down so people can't maybe change the text that we have written in here, or they can't mess with any of the things that we have. And what we're going to do is go to this restrict editing right here. So if you choose this, now take a look over on the side, it says editing restrictions. So click this and drop down, and it's going to be filling in forms is what we want to choose. Once we do this, we can put a passcode by saying yes, start enforcing protection. So I select this and we make up a password on this one, and I'll make this very simple. Hit OK. Now, if you notice, if I go back over to this and I try to click into different spots, I can't do anything. I can fill out the form. It lets me put in different things in different areas, but it doesn't allow me to change anything else in here. So even the header, if I try to change nothing, I can't make any changes at all. If I want to take that off, I could just hit restrict editing, and you can see at the very bottom, it says stop protection right here. So I can go click it. I would put in my passcode and hit OK. Oh, you got to make sure you have it correct here. I think that should do it. 1, 2, 3 is what I had for that one. And then at this point, I can go and make some changes. So like I said, if you don't want the lines from your table, you can go ahead and go back to home and then do the drop down. And you can see different options as I hover over different ones. And if I say no border, then it will look like this. So it's your choice what you want to do to it. So I hope you like this little tutorial on how to create a form in Microsoft Word. Once you add that developer tab, it's pretty simple to go through and then quickly add, and you can really lock down, making it easier for people to go through and select just the options that you give them in a place that you don't want them to be writing outside of. So thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.